Welcome to Truro, Nova Scotia for the 2018 Hockey Nova Scotia Day of Champions. It is time for the Peewee AA Provincial Championship game being played between the Halifax Hawks and the Cumberland County Ramblers. Good afternoon, Cameron McCachran with you, bringing you the call on TV1 as we have been throughout the weekend and will continue to do, as many provincial banners being handed out this weekend in Truro. It's the Peewee AA banner up for grabs here this afternoon. A hard shot there off a one-timer, right on goal. And a nice save there by the Hawks goaltender, Isaac Manette. This puck behind the net and into the corner, a battle for it there as Smith is after it for the Hawks. Cumberland County to the forecheck here. Back to the point, a quick shot right on. That one just sails wide of Manette. Going to be picked up by McDougal, who plays it back. And now up ahead, the Hawks carrying ahead. That one shot towards the goal by Smith. It's blocked, and Smith's in there one on five as the Hawks change. That shot deflected on the way through, and it's going to be carried out now by the Ramblers. Young gets that one over the line for Halifax. And the Hawks try to go to work, though. That one turned over. And Edwards backhands it high as Cumberland getting a change in. Turnover there. And again, it's Edwards on the forecheck, forcing that one, but it's going to be moved up the ice now. And in over the line with it. That's Young. Put it towards the goal. And it'll be smothered and held on to here by Remington. Face off to Remington's right. Shot right on, and a nice save there by Remington. Saw that one all the way. That one being fired in by the captain of this Hawks squad, Legere. Another shot towards the goal. That one's handled, but pops loose, and the Hawks still with pressure on. This one chipped up the wall by Halifax. And ahead for Chasson. Plays it up. And a penalty coming up now against the Cumberland County Ramblers. A tripping call. And that one goes against Nickerson, who heads off for 2 minutes here, putting the Halifax Hawks on the first power play of the game. Puck dumped down the ice as it was loose in the high slot there, but collected and fired down by Cumberland. 11:50 remaining in the first period, no score in this one, and it's the Hawks to the power play. That one gets past McDougal, and it's fired into the bench. So a faceoff will come back into the Ramblers zone. Just to the left of goaltender Remington. play back to the point. Taking a look right in front, and a great play there by the Hawks as Walworth threw that one towards the slot. Merritt redirected it just wide. But a great opportunity there on the power play for Halifax, who have to retreat now and start this breakout over. Turnover there in the neutral zone. And that's going to be fired in on goal by Bede for the Ramblers. McDougal mishandles that one on the wall. Now she'll have a chance, skates onto it. McDougal looking back, feeds that one to Smith. Smith cross ice, and that one just rolls off the stick of Robichaud. This one gloved down and now picked up by Smith. We'll backhand that one in and heads off for a change. 35 seconds to go in this power play as it's dumped down the ice once again by Cumberland County. Turnover there. Sears again dumping it in. And the Hawks created a few opportunities, and now that one driven into the crease. So the Hawks giving up some chances of their own with the man advantage here. This one in behind the goal puck is loose, and don't think that Remington knew where it was. Remington's lost his stick as well. Wraparound attempt there. Big save as it was Gavas trying to stuff that one in. Puck rolls all the way down on goaltender Isaac Minette. And he hangs on. 9:58 to go here in period number one. No score in this one between Cumberland and Halifax for the Peewee AA title. This puck moved ahead now, carried over the line and in deep there by Clothier. D-to-D pass and dumped in deep. Merritt on it for Halifax down low. And that puck is loose. A tangle of bodies in front of the net. This one will get out. Just slips past Chasson at the line. And now played right back up for Clothier. Offside the call on this one. 9:11 to play here in period number one. No score in this PWAA championship game. It's an impressive season for both of these squads. Cumberland County, the North Conference champions, coming into this. A 13-2-5 record in league play. A couple of tournament wins this year as well. They won their home tournament and one in Dieppe as well. Finished first in the Mainland League during the regular season, so a very solid program here for Cumberland County, and that is how they treated it, as I understand it, as a program. Players having off-ice training sessions and even homework at times, as that shot is lobbed in on goal and easily handled there by Minette. Shot on by Nickerson. 8:36 to play here in the first period. And no score between Cumberland County and Halifax. Back to the point. Now work down the wall. And that one's onto the stick there for Nickerson. Two Nickersons in this game, one on each side. The puck comes back to the point. And now McNally will have to hustle back. Walking in, that shot is just wide by Young. And that puck played through the crease, again fired towards the net by Halifax. And into the corner now, a chance for Cumberland County to clear it out. It will get out to neutral ice, and chasing this one down. Quick shot towards the net. That one's up into the padding of the defender as Edwards got one off there. And now a chance for Cumberland County on the rush. Walking in with a quick shot and a nice pad save there by the net. But a great opportunity off of that turnover and catching Halifax on a change. McDonald steamed up the wing there. Now it's Halifax back the other way. That shot is just wide. Just played in towards the front of the crease there, and it's a good chance for Gavaz, who tried to dump it in there. That puck dumped up the wall, and now Chasson has it. Is it poked away? Over the line now for Halifax, but unable to establish any possession with it on the attack as it's pushed right back into the neutral zone by Arsenault. Now a turnover, walking in with a chance here, but that one just got away from Chasson. He's just going to play it back instead to the blue line, and a quick shot here, deflected in front. And Legere just hammered that one towards the goal for the Hawks. Again, Legere stepping up there and clearing the zone. Legere locking down that defensive end, but now a great chance. They score. A deflection in front lands right on the stick at the side of the net. And that one squeaks over the line. The Cumberland County Ramblers strike first in this Peewee AA championship game. And I believe it's going to be Alex Herrett who gets credit for that one just on the doorstep. That one took a hop off of the stick and landed right in Harrett's wheelhouse. Pass ahead for McDougal.
Once again, Ramblers goal, scorer number 7, Alex Harrett.
Selah McDougal with it. She'll just reverse and throw that one down the wall. Now a cross-ice pass as the Hawks go back to work here. Cumberland County getting one first, and now the Hawks strike right back. They score on a similar play right at the side of the net. That one's just banged into the open cage. And the Halifax Hawks strike right back. I believe that may be Mitchell Smith, who ultimately got the shot off on that one.
Halifax Hawks first goal of the game. Score number 12, Mitchell Smith. Assist by number 11, Lewis Walker. Time of the marker, 9:35.
And it will indeed be Mitchell Smith getting credit.
Score for number 12, Mitchell Smith.
For the Hawks' first goal, just seconds after the Cumberland County Ramblers got on the board with a goal from Alex Herrett. Now the Hawks have tied things up, and we are back to even here in Truro. Penalty coming up, though. It's going to be a body-checking call against the Halifax Hawks, so a power play coming up as Bryden Klo heads off for the Hawks, and now Cumberland County getting a power play opportunity, scoring just moments ago. But things tied up quickly, so a chance to reestablish that lead now for Cumberland County as they battle for it in the neutral zone. And that one will be lifted all the way down the ice by Robichaud. Pass across for Sears through the middle of the ice. Sears spots a man up ahead. Nice move there as Nickerson trying to cause some trouble there on the defensive side of things for the Hawks. Hawks trying to just clear this one out. It will get over the line. McDonald stops it just in the neutral zone. And turned over there at the line, dumped back down the ice by the Hawks. Still battling for it here. Sears moves that one up ahead. And that shot caught McBurney right in the hand. And in some discomfort as Aiden McBurney heads right to the bench, took that shot, a clearing attempt right in the fingers there. So getting some attention on the bench, hopefully just a pain thing rather than an injury thing. And now a tripping call is coming up. This one also going against the Halifax Hawks as Luke Chasson heads off. So we will have a 40-second 5-on-3 advantage for the Cumberland County Ramblers. A big opportunity now to at least get one. That one, though, will squirt through the feet of the defender, McDonald, who was trying to keep it in there at the line. Handed off and now carried in by Bede. Back to the point, big shot, deflected as a nice block there. Side of the net, the Ramblers try to stuff that one in. It rolls just wide of the post. Back to the point, played across there by McDonald. Back to Reese McDonald, number 5 for Cumberland County, fires that one off the blocker. Puck will be knocked down, back to 5-on-4 here, so the two-man advantage over. Great job to keep that one in by Reese McDonald at the line, into the slot with a big shot. That one's just high and over the net there, but what a bullet. That one was ripped on goal by Aiden McBurney back out there after taking that clearing attempt in the hand. Kind of smarted, but none the worse for wear as he showed with that shot. Puck at the side of the net. That chip play almost into the top corner, just over the goal. Back to the point. McDonald fanned on that one, but still has it. Reese McDonald will backhand that one in deep. This puck will pop loose as the defender went down. That was McDonald, and now walking in, a chance there for the Hawks as Klo made a nice move to get around his defender, but took quite the whack on the way by, so it's going to be a slashing call against the Cumberland County Ramblers. So the Hawks managed to kill off a 5-on-3, and in 11 seconds they'll have a power play of their own. A little bit of 4-on-4 action here just briefly, as this face-off is controlled by Cumberland County rather in their own zone. Puck will be dumped out to neutralize by Halifax. MacDougall just missed that one, and now it's Nickerson back to pick it up here. Goes cross ice. Cela McDougall. That one bouncing around. McDougall plays it ahead. Puck chipped around and walking in with a quick shot there. A nice chance by Robichaud on the rush there for Halifax. This will be chopped down the ice by the Ramblers as we're into the final minute now in period number 1. Tied up here, a goal apiece. This puck worked up the wing. And now carried out by Merritt. Finn Merritt, cross ice, gets it over to Smith, who's walking in. Smith pulls up on the wall, tries to go back to the defender, but no one there to pick it up. Lienwand will go D to D. Cross for Legere, who winds up and hammers that one as he crosses the blue line. It's just high and wide. Right out front, Smith with a chance and a rebound right in front. They score with just 4 seconds on the clock. The Halifax Hawks take the lead. Another net front scramble ends up in the back of the goal. A couple of whacks at that one, and finally, it ends up in the back of the net. Sheila McDougal getting credit for that one. So 2-1 for the Halifax Hawks as they score in the dying seconds of that first period to jump out to their first lead of this game. They'll try to keep that rolling in the second period. We'll have that for you next from the 2018 Hockey Nova Scotia Day of Champions in Truro, Nova. Welcome back for second period action in this Peewee AA Championship game in Truro for the 2018 Hockey Nova Scotia Day of Champions. This puck rolls in on goal, and it'll be smothered and held on to by Minette. Just a few seconds into the second period, just a few seconds left in that first period, it was the Hawks scoring. Sheila McDougal giving them their first lead of the game. Cumberland County opened the scoring in this one. A goal from Alex Herrett, and the Hawks quickly striking back as they got one from Smith, and then McDougal gave them the lead late in that period. So a 2-1 lead for Halifax as we begin the second. Allen out of play. And as I've been doing for the other games so far, if you are tuning in, know that we always have people watching from far and wide, so if you are following along wherever it may be, just down the road or another continent, that would be cool. I don't think we've had another continent yet this weekend. You can send a tweet and let me know where you're watching from. As this puck is worked up the left wing here by Cumberland County, a wrist shot just misses wide from the point. Kara will jump up to chip that one into the corner. Back to Carr, who snaps that one towards the goal. That one is just wide. And now Halifax leading the rush out into the neutral zone. Played ahead and carrying that one. And it's knocked off the stick of Klo. Comes back to Welsh. And there's a penalty coming up here for Klo, who bumps his man into the boards and we'll head off on a body checking call. As I mentioned, if you wanted to send a shout out or get a shout out, if you're tuning in, let me know where you're watching from. Let me know who you're cheering on. And you can send me a tweet again, that handle at Cam McCachern. That's me, CamMacEachern. Maybe give you a shout out here. during this Peewee AA Championship game. The Halifax Hawks lead 2-1, but on the penalty kill now. And a chance for the Ramblers, who could not score in a 5-on-3 earlier in that first period. And obviously would like to tie things up here quickly. Carried ahead by McBurney. He's bumped as he crosses the line. He's going to be carried back now by Clothier. Doesn't get out. And now it's Cumberland. Back to work. McDonald sends that one down low. Bede tries to take it out of the off the wall and throw it down to the goal line. It's deflected, and now Halifax trying to clear that one out. It's going to be kept in, though, at the blue line by McDonald. And the other McDonald picking it up here. That's Ben McDonald off the wall for Reese McDonald, who carries it ahead. That one will be kept in at the line and now driven into the corner by Cumberland. Some good pressure on this power play. Bede takes it. Back to Bede, gets the return pass, a nice give and go there. With 25 seconds remaining on the power play advantage here, Cumberland looking good, moving that puck around nicely. This one's carried in by McBurney. Puck right out from McDonald, a quick shot, they score! Ben McDonald takes that pass high in the zone. Takes a look and snaps that one home. He ties it up here for his Cumberland County Ramblers on the power play. And it's 2-2 in the second period. Hawks trying to clear the zone. Kept in, though, by Edwards. Now it gets out, but ran into possession of the Ramblers.
Scored by number 10, Ben McDonald.
Welsh, cross-ice pass. McDougal goes cross-ice back the other way. Gets it up to Merritt. Smith chips that one back. That shot towards the goal. Bank pass behind the Hawks net. They struggle to get this one out. Pass across there by Welsh, fanned on. Good forechecking pressure here by the Ramblers. Another chance now for the Hawks as Walworth played that one behind the net, and now it will get out. It's up ahead for Selah McDougal. She's in, but stripped there as that one was taken away off her stick. Good work there by Harrett on the back check. Snap right on. Harrett heading for the rebound. And a nice rush there by Cumberland. Good back check by Harrett to start it off. And a nice opportunity by the Ramblers, who have tied things up here on a goal by Captain Ben McDonald. He snaps one home on the power play. And less than 10 to play in the second period, a tie game. Looks like we have got a dandy brewing in this one. This is going to be carried in and slapped around behind the net by Gavas. puck fired towards the net. Deflected. This one's chipped ahead. Backhanded now in by Nickerson for Halifax. Cleared out by the Ramblers out to neutral ice, and the Hawks quickly work it back up. Ross just missed that one. In on the forecheck now, Ross. And that puck took a hop off the linesman's bucket, I do believe. Hit him in the helmet there. Seems to be none the worse for wear, though. Cumberland trying to get this one out. It's going to be kicked from just outside the line. So offside, they have to tag up. And now it's a 2-on-1 the other way for Cumberland. Walking in with a quick shot. And Harrit robbed there. Good chance for Alex Harrit, who just gets taken into the boards from behind. And it's going to be a penalty.
Too much of a good thing is not always a good thing. Early sports specialization is on the rise in new sports.
Nice rush by Alex Harrit, who opened the scoring in this game. Almost had another one and ended up getting hauled down. So power play coming up for the Cumberland County Ramblers. There's the captain, Ethan Legere, is off for a trip. It's going to be chipped off the wall and in by Carr. Bede puts it down low. Comes right back out. McDonald leaves it there for Carr. Carr is going to try to fire that one in. Takes a hop off of the legs of the Halifax forward coming out to block that one. A great block by Merritt. Sent it down the ice with the block and got off to the bench in a bit of pain. Bede chasing this one down for the Ramblers. Back to the point. Carr with a quick shot. That one, a riser over the net. Carr again. Cross ice for McDonald. McDonald goes down low to Bede. Back to Bede with a quick shot. He scores! Burke Bede. With a little give and go. He's tried that play a couple of times on the power play already, and this time it works. Dishes it down to the goal line, takes the immediate return feed, and just snaps that one past the goaltender, Manette. And a big goal as the Cumberland County Ramblers ahead 3-2. Burke Bede with the go-ahead goal for Cumberland County, and they've regained the lead.
Cumberland County's power play goal. Score by number 3, Burke Bede. Assistant referee, assistant captain, Kieran Sears. And the 5, Reese McDonald. Top of the Ramblers marker, Ian Ofo. Once again, power play goal, score by number 3, Burke Bede. Assistant by number 9,
that puck played towards the net by the Ramblers, and now not cleared out. A quick shot towards the goal. That one's blockered aside as Nickerson got one in for Cumberland County, who are on the attack now. They've taken the lead, and they are pressing. Nickerson plays it down low. Right out to the slot. A quick shot right on. And a big save there by Manette. And legs not moving a whole lot out there for the Hawks right now, as the Cumberland County Ramblers moving that one around nicely in the offensive zone. Hawks could use a spark here after giving up that go-ahead goal. This puck comes back to Reese McDonald, who winds up. That one's deflected in front. Picked up now by Chasson, who moves it ahead. Gets that one to Ross. Ross is over the line. Backhanded towards the net. And McDonald will pick it up and play it ahead for the Ramblers. Couple of nice moves, but unable to clear that one out. And that puck needs to get out. The Hawks right back the other way. And that one's broken up. Carried back out, moved ahead. McBurney almost in alone. And now an offside call on that play with 5:11 remaining in the second period. 3-2 the score. The Halifax Hawks trail in this one. Burke Bead, the go-ahead goal on the power play moments ago for the Ramblers. That puck will be cleared out, just gets past Legere at the blue line and all the way down the ice. Legere collects it now for Halifax. Scramble for this in the neutral zone. Legere will step up and skate it ahead. Ethan Legere with a few nice moves. Walking in Legere to the backhand. He fires that one right on. And what a rush by the captain. Ethan Legere gets that one right on goal. And a big save there by the goaltender for the Cumberland County Ramblers, Phoenix Remington. Hasn't had a ton of work so far, but a sharp save on that one as this one's moved ahead to Harrit, looking for a lane. Harrit will play it up and it'll be carried in now by Sears. Sears walking in, just about chips that one into the far corner. Puck is loose. McDougal tries to pass ahead, but now Harrit is chopping at it for Cumberland County. It's into the Halifax zone now. Turnover there, nearly. And that's a dangerous play. Walworth almost coughed that one up right in front, but now moves it behind the net and starts the breakout here for the Hawks. That one's played up by Merritt. Quick shot towards the net there. McDougal put one on, and Smith in on the forecheck as well. Sears tries to slide that one across in the backhand. It's going to be picked off by Smith and moved out to the neutral zone. Hawks in possession. Smith will get this one right back and goes up ahead for Merritt. He just dumps it in, and solid shift there for that Halifax line. They'll change up. Carried back the other way now by Sears. He's working towards the middle. Sears snaps that one right on, right back on it behind the net. Tries to chip it around the defender there, but couldn't get it past Robichaud. Cross ice pass now. Gavas up ice for Klo. Cuts wide and just fires that one towards the net. No trouble there for Remington. And over in the neutral zone is swatted ahead by Edwards. Quick shot, and that one deflected off of the stick of a car right in front. Almost took a funny hop there. Could have been a dangerous one. Bede ahead with it now for Cumberland. Fires that one on. He's in 1-on-4. Just trying to keep it alive in the offensive zone right now. Pass off of the boards. Picked off by McDonald, but he carries it in offside with 1:50 remaining in the second period. 3-2 the score as Cumberland County has a lead on Halifax. A couple of goals in this second period. One from Ben McDonald, and the latest coming from Burke Bead on the power play, who has the Ramblers ahead. 3-2. McBurney over the line. Quick shot, that one right in on goal and saved, held on to. Bennett has had plenty of work so far. Shots 17-9 in favor of the Cumberland County Ramblers, and they have it again. Puck back to McDonald at the line. He'll throw it down the wall. Picked up and played around by Clothier. And now Chason on it, chasing it down in the corner for Halifax. Arsenault trying to avoid traffic there below the goal line. And it will be Cumberland County carrying it ahead. McBurney over the blue line. Quick shot from the side of the goal, a sharp angle there, and it's handled no problem by Manette. Pass up to Neutralice. It's broken up and dumped back in by the Ramblers. A puck fired down the ice. It'll be an icing call against the Halifax Hawks, who are down 3-2 in this one. 41 seconds to go in the second period, and real chance now for Cumberland to head into this intermission with a lead. A nice back and forth game. Cumberland opened the scoring in the first period. Halifax got it right back and then added another to take a 2-1 lead, and now it's Cumberland with a pair of their own to lead 3-2. 30 seconds remaining in the second period, and this one's chipped deep into the Cumberland zone. There's Reed, or Carr rather, firing that one around. This puck is in the corner. Ramblers able to clear it out and get all the way down the ice here. Walworth is back to handle it, and that's going to do it for two periods of play. 30 minutes in the books, and we have a 3-2 lead for the Cumberland County Ramblers over the Halifax Hawks in this Peewee AA Provincial Championship. A great game brewing here, and it should be an excellent third. Hope you'll stick around for it. We'll have it for you shortly here on TV1 from the 2018 Hockey Nova Scotia Day of Champions in Truro, Nova Scotia. Welcome back to Truro for third period action. It is the Peewee AA Provincial Championship game, and the Cumberland County Ramblers have a 3-2 lead after two periods of play, and they're on the attack early. Behind the net, moved back to the point now, and back down low along the half wall. That one's just out of the reach of McBurney. That puck played ahead. Deep into the Ramblers zone now. And they'll fire that one up the wall. That pass right through the crease by Lane Wand. And now the Ramblers back on it behind the net, trying to fire that one around again. Lane Wand jumping up on the play to keep that one alive. Picked up and backhanded ahead. Now a chance. That one just out of the reach. It was almost a breakaway. A great chance there for Ethan Rose. And that one just out of his reach. Threw it out front and it took a hop. Almost surprised the goaltender there as Rose almost had another good chance. McBurney forces a turnover at the blue line and hammers that one back down the ice. Clothier into the corner. And he is hauled down. So a trip will be called against the Cumberland County Ramblers. A power play coming up for Halifax. Carr headed off for the Ramblers, so an early power play in the third period, just a minute 45 into this frame, and it's the Hawks with a chance to equalize. They trail 3-2. A great back and forth game in this one. Puck loose and bopping around there in the slot. Finally ends up in the corner. Cumberland trying to clear it out. They will get it out to neutral ice. It rolls all the way down into the defensive zone, and the captain, Legere, is back to pick it up for Halifax. Goes all the way up the ice. Puts it on the tape there for Clothier. Sends it back to the point. Walworth tried to go back to Clothier. Had it taken away and dumped down the ice by the Ramblers. A minute 10 remaining on the power play here as Halifax looks to tie this up. McBurney gets to that one. The pass missed and able to get it back deep for Cumberland County. Moved ahead now by Halifax. McDougal pulls up at the line, and that's going to be an offside, so they need to tag up here and gives Cumberland a chance to dump it right back down the ice. 43 seconds remaining in the power play. Just under 12 minutes remaining in the third here. It's McBurney again fires that one in deep. Pass ahead for Smith. Got ahead of steam trying to truck through the middle of the ice there, had it poked away, and now dumped all the way down the ice by Cumberland. Just 10 seconds to go on that power play. Maybe one last rush here for the Hawks. Cross ice pass, a long stretch one up ahead. And that one just rolled off the stick of Young. Puck played there by the goaltender, Remington. Turned over. Halifax still with it in the attacking zone. Backhanded in by Lean Wand. Turnover, pounced on by Nickerson, who gets it to the red line, but taken away. The Hawks just trying to dump that one in deep. It took a hop, and puck just bouncing around out there right now.
Heavy bump along the boards there by Legier.
Shot rolls in from the point, a tip in front, and sends it just wide into the corner by the Ramblers. Halifax carrying ahead. Klo goes cross ice. That one's off the skate of Gavas. He gives chase. Puck dumped out ahead. And Bede is tangled up trying to find that one. The Hawks tag up and go back to the attack. Long pass for Nickerson is going to be picked off there. Nickerson will get to it and chop it out to the neutral zone. And now Halifax back to collect. Robichaud goes D to D for his partner Nickerson, who dumps it in there for the Hawks. A pretty tentative pace here in this third period. 5.5 minutes in. Now a chance. Chason fanned on that shot. Throws it right out front. Rebound is loose. Battling for it there. A quick shot. Again, deflected right in front. That was Clothier putting one on net, but had it hit a shin pad. And dumped down the ice now. No icing. Right out front, and a chance there for the Ramblers. Another shot, and another rebound, and a big save. Sprawling out with the pad there. And Isaac Manette. A couple of big stops on that one, as he thought that that puck was cleared out from the opposite end of center ice. He was calling for the icing. Didn't get it, and an excellent couple of opportunities created as a result by the Ramblers. So Manette was sharp. After not playing that puck, he recovered nicely to make a few big stops there at a key moment. 3-2, Cumberland leading, and another goal there would have been a tough one with this little time on the clock. D-to-D pass. Skated right through the middle of the ice now, and still with it before it's finally taken away from Legier. Or rather Welsh, excuse me, on that rush. Puck dumped in, Walworth is back to collect. Skating behind the net. Puck dumped in, Klo after it for Halifax. Puck turned over, trying to spring Bede through the middle of the ice. Quick shot there as that pass came right to the slot. And a great opportunity in tight for Rose. An excellent pass by Bede out of the corner to set that one up. Halifax trying to get a handle on this breakout. Coughed up, and now it's back for Carr. Handling it. Played ahead. Got it to Bede to try to dump it in, but put it on the tape there for Legier, who quickly makes the play ahead, springs his man, but that one rolls off the stick. The Young back on the attack. Now Chason throws that one across the crease. Right back out front by Gavas. And almost connected there with Lienwald. Lienwald up over the blue line, pulling up, and will shovel that one behind the Ramblers' net. Be frozen along the wall. .638 to play here in period number three. A 3-2 lead for the Cumberland County Ramblers. Mentioned earlier in the game all of the Ramblers' successes, lots of tournament wins, of course, the same can be said for Halifax. They won the Jordan Boyd tournament this year. Also won at the Moncton Challenge. And of course, rolled right through to become the South Conference champions, and represent the South here at the Day of Champions. Less than six on the clock here for the Halifax Hawks as they're over the blue line. Into the corner, and after it is Merritt. Played behind the net. McDougal will get there. Played up the wall. And here's Bede carrying this one ahead. Bede winds up and cranks that one on goal. Save made by Manette. And that puck took a funny hop right in front as it took a strange deflection. Popped up in the air and came right down on top of goaltender Manette. The official blows this one down. 5:17 remaining in the third period. A 3-2 lead for Cumberland County. The Hawks trying to come back, and you know they would love to, especially for their coach. Head coach Dave, and I hope I'm getting this right, Zakirakis, who battled cancer through the course of this season, and obviously team looking to make things happen for him, but they will have a two-goal deficit to climb out of now as it's the Cumberland County Ramblers. Just squeaking that one over the line. 5:02 remaining here in period number three, and that is a tough one to take for Halifax. They've pushed back nicely at times here in the third period, but Cumberland County still dangerous. And they get one here to create a two-goal lead in the third. Ethan Rose getting the goal. Rose had a great chance just a little earlier and just missed a breakaway pass. He came back to the bench, was shaking his head, a little frustrated with himself, so I'm sure very relieved to get that goal. And what a goal it is at an important time here for his Cumberland County Ramblers. A two-goal lead now with 4:16 on the clock. Perhaps a bit of insurance here, as I mentioned, as that goal was being scored. Dave Zagarakis, the head coach of this Halifax squad, battling cancer this season, and obviously that's a tough thing to go through, so you know that the team is fully behind him and would love to get the win here for their coach. The other end, on the other bench. So a fair bit of experience on that coaching staff. There's head coach Jeff Welsh. As that one's right in on goal, and a kick save there. Scramble for it right in front. Head coach Jeff Welsh was an assistant with the Amherst Ramblers in the Junior A League for a couple of years. He actually assisted Corey Crocker, who was the head coach and GM for seven seasons, and they've reversed roles. Crocker now an assistant coach with this Peewee AA squad from Cumberland, and Jeff Walsh the head coach of this team. So a fair bit of experience for these kids to draw on. And they have a 4-2 lead here, but it's a power play opportunity now for the Halifax Hawks with 3.5 to go. And the chance to get back within one. That puck will be kept in just barely by Legier at the line. Dumps it in deep for Chasson. Poitier back to the point for Legier. Looking for an option. Legier goes across for Lean Wand. That one's going to be poked away, and now an odd man rush shaping up here for the Ramblers. McBurney going to the net, backhanded towards the goal, and McBurney will pick it up here. Going to play it back as the Ramblers try to kill off some time. 3 minutes remaining, and just a minute 25 to go here on the power play for this Halifax Hawks squad. Clock is ticking. Chason after the corner. It'll be dumped back down by Cumberland County. Walking over the line, Legere winds up and hammers a low shot right on. And a good save there by Phoenix Remington. Shots 23-14 in favor of the Cumberland County Ramblers. So Remington has been solid back there. Hasn't made a ton of those huge saves, but stopping what he's needed to stop back there. Pass ahead for McDougal with the net empty. Bit of 6-on-4 action right now for Halifax as they try to crawl back into this one. Less than 2 minutes remaining in this game. Pass ahead for McDougal, who backhands it up for Merritt. Disrupts that clearing attempt, and Halifax is on it. Down low for Merritt. So he's going to get back through the line and all the way out. Minute 35 remaining here in the third period. Here's McDougal over the line. Leaves it there for Clothier, walking in. Has that poked away. Clothier in the corner. Behind the net there. Got it to Merritt. And now McDonald with it will try to lift that one down the ice, but it's going to be kept in by Smith. Just a minute 4 here. So clock is ticking. Power play is over. So just a 6-on-5 now. And a penalty coming up for the Halifax Hawks, I do believe. It's going to be a hold. And that is a tough break for Halifax. Down by 2 here in the final minute of the third period. Excuse me, it actually looks like it will be a Cumberland County penalty. It looked like one of the Hawks had been flagged on that one, but it is a 2-minute penalty for Cumberland County. So wanted to send another shout out. Have been doing this through the course of the last couple days, and got a tweet from Ren cheering on the Cumberland County Ramblers, and has folks watching in Florida and Alberta. So always cool to hear that folks are tuning in from a distance. Thank you for listening, and if you are out there tuning in, wanted to get a shout out in, maybe I'll be able to fit in one here before we wrap up at Cam McCackern on Twitter. 52.7 on the clock, and 6-on-4 for the Hawks. Down by 2. They need a big effort here. This one comes back to the point. Played across for Legere. Winds up and fires a hard one. He scores! There's one. What a shot by the captain, Ethan Legere. Winds that up and hammers it from the blue line. A hard, low shot that beats the goaltender, Remington. And we've got another timeout called here. And we have got a finish coming up. 8 seconds it took the Halifax Hawks to get back within one after that face-off.
Score by number 9, Ethan Lutcher. Assistant by number 12, Mitchell Smith. And number 44. Time of the marker, 14:16.
So the clock ticking now, and an icing call right off the hop here against Cumberland County.
Once again, Hawks call play goal. Score number 9, Ethan Lutcher. Assist by number 12, Mitchell Smith. Number 14, Daniel Anderson. Time to power play marker, 14:16.
Six attackers out there now for Halifax, with the goaltender on the bench. A hard shot is wide, whacking away at the side of the net. 30 seconds on the clock. Puck is loose in the corner, pinching up on that one. Welsh throws it towards the front of the net. It's loose. Quick shot from the point, tipped in front. Remington didn't see that one. Shot from the side of the net. Clothier trying to stuff it in. Throws out front. It's loose. Battle for it. It's in. They score. The Halifax Hawks tie it. 13.4 on the clock. And they score twice in the final minute to tie this one up. Well, what a sequence of events here in Truro. 13.4 on the clock. The Halifax Hawks have tied this one up, trailing 4-2 in the final minute. And a couple more chances in those final seconds for the Hawks. And they almost end this one in regulation. Drew Clothier, the hero here, tying this one up with just 13 seconds remaining on the clock. And you can bet that the Halifax Hawks are amped down there right now. They are juiced up. And the Cumberland County Ramblers just trying to get their feet back under them here, as Halifax has all of the momentum on their side heading into this overtime. So it will be an exciting finish to this one. Stick around. We've got a fun overtime on tap here. The Cumberland County Ramblers and the Halifax Hawks all tied up at 4. We've got OT for you next. And here we go. Overtime underway. The Cumberland County Ramblers, the Halifax Hawks, 4-on-4 for 5 minutes. And what a finish we have in store for this one. An excellent game all the way through. Cumberland County leading 4-2 in the final minute, but it's the Halifax Hawks. Cardiac kids here. They strike twice and tie it up late, forcing overtime. Here's Ethan Legere. He's got an extra pep in his step. Scored that third goal with 44 seconds remaining. Picked up now by Smith. Throws down the brakes and looks for an option. Smith stick handling ahead. Mitchell Smith over the line. Has that one knocked off his stick. And it'll be moved ahead. Walking in now with a chance. A quick shot. That one is high over the net. and back the other way. Welsh with it. Offside the call here as the Hawks tried to return to the attack, but blown dead on the offside. 3:46 to go in the overtime frame. 4-on-4 right now. Halifax coming back late and tying this game with a pair of goals in the final minute. Final 44 seconds, in fact. They scored twice in about 31 seconds in that final minute. And now a chance. Clothier right in front. Whips that one just wide. A great chance for Drew Clothier, who tied this thing up. Just 13 seconds remaining. Back to the point now. Quick shot there. And put right on net by Walworth, but a good save by Remington. Hangs on to it. 3:17 to play here in the overtime period. McDougal and Gavas out there for the Hawks up front. Turnover there. Almost driven back the other way, but taken right back by Legere, who carries it ahead. In over the line. Legere battling for it there. Now McDougal tries to slide that one to the slot. It's going to be picked off and thrown to the line, but kept in by Legere. Backhands it down low for McDougal. She tries to find Linewand, who was pinching in there, but had the pass deflected. Now a chance for the Ramblers. Great back pressure there by Linewand to break that one up, and now takes it away in the corner. Quick snap from the line is knocked down, and 3-on-2 shaping up here for Halifax. Linewand carrying it ahead over the line. That one's going to be chipped off the wall. And now Smith carries it in offside. 2:15 remaining in the overtime period. 4-4 in this one. And what a finish. Cumberland County leading this one. 4-2 for much of that third period. And ultimately, Halifax getting two back in the final minute. Now pushing for the win. Welsh dishes that one off. It's going to be thrown back in deep, but the turnover now. Walworth picks that one off at the line, throws it towards the net. It was loose there for a moment. Walworth after it again, able to keep it in there at the line. Good work there by Walworth. Played up ahead now, McDonald pinching in. The defender, McDonald, throws it right in front. It deflects, and they score! A freak goal, and Reese McDonald has the game winner for the Cumberland County Ramblers. McDonald steams up the right wing, tries to slide that pass in front of the net. It takes a hop off of a skate and ends up in the back of the net. A heartbreaker for the Halifax Hawks, and a heartbreaker for Isaac Manette, who was fantastic in this game, and to get beaten on that one. Just a tough break as he was sliding across trying to take the pass, and just a bad bounce for Halifax slides into their goal. Cumberland County ends up salvaging a victory from this one, leading 4-2 in the final minute and dominant for stretches of this one. Cumberland County locked down the win after almost coughing it up there late. 4-2, two goals in 31 seconds by the Halifax Hawks to tie this thing. And you had to like their momentum going into the opening minutes of this overtime frame, but things settled down. And the Cumberland County Ramblers are the 2018 Peewee AA Provincial Champions. What a finish, and what a treat for the fans here in Truro. This was an excellent game, and a great finish to this one, and what a heartbreaker for this Hawks squad, who just fought tooth and nail to get back in this one in the final minute and end up losing the provincial banner on a wild bounce like that. That is just hockey sometimes, and again, a tough one to take for the Halifax Hawks, but what a win for the Cumberland County Ramblers as they capture the 2018 Nova Scotia Peewee AA title. We'll have the player of the game announcements and the presentation of the medals and, of course, the championship trophy and provincial banner. But again, the final score here, 5-4 for the Cumberland County Ramblers over the Halifax Hawks here in the Peewee AA Final at the 2018 Hockey Nova Scotia Day of Champions in Truro. The action will continue. That will do it for my coverage for the day, but stick around and Dan will be back in with you for the remainder of these games, and I'll be back at it tomorrow for some girls hockey action. Very excited for the final day of the Day of Champions. Again, the final 5-4 for the Cumberland County Ramblers in the Peewee AA Final, an overtime win for the banner. Thanks for joining us for the Day of Champions from Truro, Nova Scotia.
Hockey Nova Scotia, player of the game for the Halifax Hawks, goes to number 12, Mitchell Smith. Boston Pizza's Trills Most Sports for Life Player of the Game Award for the Halifax Hawks goes to number 9, Ethan Legere. Boston Pizza's Most Sportsmanlike Player of the Game for the gold medal winners, the Cumberland County Ramblers. Manning the Pipes, number 1, Phoenix Remington. And finally, the Hoofgrove Grinder of the Game Award goes to the Ramblers, number 13, Aiden McBurney. And it's now time to award the silver medals to the Halifax Hawks. Mateo McIsaac. Also manning the pipes this year for the Halifax Hawks, number 1, Isaac Manette. On defense for the Hawks, number 7, William Robichaud. Number 8, Jackson Welch. Number 9, Ethan Mosier. Number 11, Lewis Walworth. Number 14, Daniel Nickerson. Number 15, Elijah Lindmore. At forward, number 2, Luca Chisholm. Number 4, Drew Crutcher. Number 5, Sheila McDonald-Dougal. Number 6, Sam Young. Number 10, Yargos Gavis. Number 12, Mitchell Smith. Number 16, Ben Marriott. Number 17, Brian Cloud. Number 18, Sam Ross. Coaches, Jonathan Ross, Amy Crowley, David Garbus, Nolan Healy, and Andrew Fleming. That's the 2018 silver medalists, PAA Halifax Hawks. Just a friendly reminder, no parents are to be on the ice surface. No parents on the ice surface. Photographs complimentary of Tony Gilgreen. Team of Team Impact photos from the main lobby. Free download of all the photos of today's action. It's now time to award the gold medals to the provincial champions, the Cumberland County Rambler. And the place this year for the Ramblers, number 1, Phoenix Remington. Also in the fight this year for the Cumberland County Ramblers, number 30, Hayden Crockett. On defense, number 4, assistant captain, Nate Mercillo. This man has got his name called many times today, number 5, Reese McDonald. Number 8, assistant captain, Jimmy Kerr. Number 10, team captain, Ben McDonald. Number 14, Nolan McNally. At forward, number 2, Sammy Madison. Number 3, Bert B. Number 7, Alex Perret. Number 9, assistant captain, Kieran Sears. Number 11, Linda Nickerson. Number 12, Ethan Roon. Number 13, Ethan McBurney. Number 15, Brady Stack. And number 17, Tyler Inberg. Major Seth Harris. Coaches Jeff Walsh, Corey Crocker, Mike Stack, and trainer Kim Madison, 2018 PAA Provincial Champions, Cumberland County Ramblers.
Download and you can see all the photos of the action and celebration out the main lobby. Thank you.